It is. Isn't it just a Hallmark moment? Maybe I was stupid telling you goodbye. Maybe I was wrong for trying to pick a fight.
Now, we want to talk about your numerous odd jobs you've had before.
Okay, that's going to be hilarious.
Kelly Clarkson. We've got on the list here. You included mowing lawns.
Yes, that sucked.
Yeah, working in a cinema.
Yes, that was fun.
And selling vacuums door to door.
That sucked.
Selling, so you'd knock on someone's door and say, buy this vacuum.
Yeah, I was horrible. I'm not a salesperson. Like, I'm like the person that's like, oh, you don't want it. Oh, that's cool. I didn't really think you wanted it.
Yeah, you don't need one. Your coffee's
fine. Anyway, I mean, you could just like sweep it over the room. Like, I was the most horrible. It was just, I really needed money. I'm just not good at sales. I know that I've got issues.
Sale technique. Did you sell me a vacuum?
Let the other guy that was in the, like, actually, I'll tell you honestly, I made it to one door. Like, and I walked it. It was like you had to do like preparations. You had to sit in this like building or whatever for like, I don't know, it was like a couple days, and then they'd teach you how to do it. And then you walk up to the door, and the guy, the other guy that was in my group, I made him do it, and then I walked to a gas station and had my friend pick me up.
That's the dedication.
I was like, this is the most horrible thing ever. I got like hyperventilate, get sweaty. I'm not.
How boring was the vacuum selling college?
I mean, people are really good at it. No, it wasn't like college, but yeah, people are really good at it. The guy that was with me was really good at it. And you can make a lot of money, but not me.
So. Not Kelly Clarkson.
Yeah.
Let's talk about the album, the fourth album.
Yeah, fourth album.
All I Ever Wanted. Yep. Sell it to me, as if you were selling me a vacuum.
Well, do I have to show my boots? No, just kidding. I'm just kidding. No, it's a great album. It's we pushed the envelope on it. We kind of made it, like, the stuff that was, you know, kind of rock pop, we pushed it a little more that way. Like, All I Ever Wanted is the title track, and it's very much like a 70s kind of funky song. You know, has one of those beats that you have to kind of do your shoulders to. I know. Okay. And then there's actually a British punk type song on there called Why You Wanna Bring Me Down, which is one of my favorites on the album. Okay. Just because I get to wail on it, and I love it. And then even the ballads are very much different than y'all heard before. Already Gone would be one of those. And it's just very sweet. There's not really a wailing point in it. It's just a message. So it's very different. Being with you is so dysfunctional. I
really shouldn't miss you, but I can't let you go. I read somewhere this is quite different. You said it was influenced by Garbage and Mozart.
Well, I didn't say that. I know that Ryan Tedder said that just because he, it is actually true though, a song that he did on the album, Save You, the whole, like, there's like this musical interlude that's so beautiful, it's classical.
Right.
Very much influenced by that, and we both love the same influence. I grew up singing that, so it was just, it's cool. The album's kind of got a little bit of everything.
Yeah, and you worked with Ryan Tedder, as you just said, for the One Republic, and also Katy Perry.
I worked with Ryan Tedder, like, we wrote together, like, on, like, six songs, and he gave me a song, and then honestly, Katy Perry, I didn't work with her in the studio. Uh-huh. I don't know this for sure, but I'm pretty sure, like, hearing her version, like, it was probably for her album, but they thought it just might be weird to have a song called I Do Not Hook Up after I Kissed a Girl.
Yeah.
So, that's kind of a contradiction.
Who are you, Katy Perry?
So, you don't?
No, I said, who are you, Katy Perry?
I was like, no.
People have been, like, saying that.
Well, that's why I like her, actually, because I'm kind of all over the place like that. I'm, you know, one... You know, when you've had a couple drinks, we're all different. So, you know, so I really dig the song, and it was like I could have written it.
Yeah.
So it was very much a message that I would say. So she wrote that song, I Do Not Hook Up. And I worked with Ryan Tedder. We did like six songs, but I think four or five made the album.
Okay, now before I came, I did some research.
Okay.
And we basically went onto like your number one fans website and pulled off a lot of facts, and I just want you to tell me if they're true or false.
Oh, okay.
So this is off of the fans website. You're related to Britain's number one motoring enthusiast, Jeremy Clarkson.
I don't think so, no.
You're actually 62 years old.
Yes.
And you physically have two left feet.
No.
You used to date Enrique's dad, Julio Iglesias.
Yes, no, I did not.
No, no. You used to have a phobia of telephones, so insist on using carrier pigeon for communication.
Of course, who doesn't?
Of course, who doesn't, right?
I used to smoke signals as well, yes.
You own your own train service called the Clarkson Express Service.
Yes, I mean, all these are so, like...
All these are true.
Yeah, very true,
well, big rumours, but now we've cleared them all
yes,
up.
Yes, now it's clear
all
that
true.
I have my own train.
All true. And Kelly Clarkson, thank you so much.
No, anytime.
Thanks a lot, Kelly Clarkson.
Have a good one.
Thank you, you too.
That was awesome.